When John Henry was a little bitty boy, sitting on his mammy's knee, he picked up a hammer and a little piece of steel. Said, this hammer gonna be the death blow to me. This hammer gonna be the death of me. Well, when John Henry was a little baby, no bigger than the palm of your hand, his mammy looked down at little Johnny and said, oh, Johnny's gonna be a steel driving man. Yes, he is. Oh, Johnny's gonna be a steel driving man. John Henry, he was a steel-driving man, drove steel all over this land. Said, before I let a steam hammer get me down, I'm gonna die with my hammer in my hand. I'm gonna die with my hammer in my hand. Well, John Henry went to the tunnel to drive, a steam hammer by his side. That mountain was so tall, John Henry was so small, that he laid down his hammer and he cried, Lord, Lord. He laid down his hammer and he cried. Well, John Henry said to his shaker, shaker, why don't you pray? If my hammer ever misses this little piece of steel, tomorrow be your burying day, Lord, Lord. Tomorrow be your burying day. And then the captain, he said to John Henry, I believe that mountain's caving in. Oh, Johnny, he just laughed at the captain and said, ain't nothing but my hammer sucking wind, Lord, Lord. That ain't nothing but my hammer sucking wind. John Henry had a loving little wife, her name was Polly Ann. Old Johnny got sick and he had to go to bed. Polly drove steel like a man, Lord, Lord. Miss Polly drove steel like a man. Well, they buried John Henry by the railroad, laid him 6 feet down in the sand. And every time a freight train would come puffing by, they'd say, yonder lays that steel driving man, Lord, Lord. Yonder lays that steel driving man.